वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन. दिस इज पार्ट थ्री एंड दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोजन इंटरेक्शन. एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर आई विल ट्राई टू यू नो कंपाइल ऑल दिस थिंग. यू नो यू ऑल्सो लर्न सो मेनी थिंग फ्रॉम योर पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस. सो प्लांट इज ऑल्सो डू द सेम एज लाइक सिमिलर टू द वैक्सीन. आपको वैक्सीन क्यों दिया जाता है? वैक्सीनेशन इज रियली यू नो sometime you have you know live attenuated or sometime hit killed or killed microorganism can you know. So vaccine is of two types. So I'm not going to discuss about vaccine here. I will just tell you how plant induces immune response whenever plant challenge second time by the same pathogen. So aapko agar wahi tarah ka insaan dobara mile jo aapko cheat karke gaya ho, यू विल लर्न फ्रॉम द पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस. जैसा वो बत्ती आपके साथ करेगा नेक्स्ट टाइम आप उससे बड़ा कॉशस रहोगे. सो प्लांट भी उसी तरह से अपने अंदर रिस्पॉन्स को क्या करता है, जनरेट करता है. इन द सेकेंड टाइम प्लांट विल रिस्पॉन्ड ड्रास्टिकली एंड मोर विगरस विच आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन यू नो आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इन यू नो दिस वाई आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट यू नो इन सेकेंड टाइम रिस्पॉन्स इज वेरी ड्रास्टिक. Very drastic because activated immune system is already into the host organism. So dear guys, you always learn from your past experience. So plant also do the same. Okay? Chaliye. So pathogen virulence activity lost. अब देखो दो चीज हो सकते हैं. या तो pathogen अपनी virulence activity को lost कर दे या प्लांट हैव जनरेटेड वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग इम्यूनिटी. दो ही तरह से प्लांट अपने आप को बचा सकता है, बच सकता है. दो ही रीजन हो सकता है ना. एक तो ये रीजन हो सकता है कि पैथोजिन की जो वायरुलेंस है, वायरुलेंस नेचर ऑफ पैथोजिन इज लॉस्ट. सो नाउ पैथोजिन इज नॉट मोर एक्टिव एज लाइक कोविड. कोविड इज रियली वेरी ड्रास्टिक राइट नाउ, बट इफ यू विल इम्यूनाइज एंड नो बडी इज गोइंग टू यू नो, अब उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है, कोविड हो ना हो कोई मतलब नहीं. So what had happened, you know, the process is immunity. So you all will immunize with that pathogen. So pathogen virulence is lost. अब वो pathogen के पास वो capacity नहीं है कि वो infect कर पाए. तो virulence जो pathogen की virulence property वो lost हो जाए, या plant have generated or you will generate very strong immunity. आपके अंदर उससे बहुत ज़्यादा immunity आपका develop हो गया और उस पैथोजिन, नाउ दैट पैथोजिन कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग इन योर बॉडी. सो दैट इज रियली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल यू थ्रू दिस यू नो एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट हाउ प्लांट एक्सपीरियंस एंड लर्न फ्रॉम द पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस. सो यू नो दिस इज द फर्स्ट इन्फेक्शन. यू नो सो फर्स्ट इन्फेक्शन क्या कहेगा, इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट रिसर्चर्स हैव टेकन टू टाइप ऑफ टू प्लांट्स. वन दे इन्फेक्ट विद द फर्स्ट टाइम इन्फेक्शन इज हैपेंड इन दिस plant and they left both, and this is the night plant. Nothing is done with that plant. So in the second time infection is again introduced in this plant. So in this plant the infection is very less, as you can see here infection is very less. But the night plant, because infection secondary inoculum is high, the plant is drastically affected by that plant pathogen. It means what? Plant have generated and learned from their past experience. So past se sikha, plant learned from their past, so they are not giving such infection pattern as night plant is showing. Okay, now come to the systemic acquired resistance and localized virus infection. So there are local immune response or systemic acquired resistance, both are very important for you guys. Now this experiment is again the same. This plant, you as you can see here, infected first, and this is really naive plant. Okay, now in the second time when they the same tobacco mosaic virus is introduced into the tobacco plant, nothing is more happened in the surface of the leaf. But as this, these are the naive plants, and this plant is drastically affected by tobacco mosaic virus, TMB. So this is really reported, guys, and this is really very informative. So understand how plant learn from their past experience. So this is the secondary immune response, primary immune response. So this is really very much important. Okay, so now you can see ये क्या हुआ कि पहले थोड़ा सा पार्ट ए अफेक्टेड था और फिर से इसको अफेक्ट किया गया. सो देर इज नो स्प्रेड ऑफ द डिजीज बट इन दिस लीफ एज यू कैन सी द TMB इज स्प्रेड ओवर द होल लीफ. व्हाई इज सो बिकॉज द फ्रॉम यू नो दिस ऑल आर द एविडेंस फॉर प्लांट हैव ऑल्सो द लर्निंग बिहेवियर फ्रॉम देयर पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस. जैसे हम लर्न करते हैं प्लांट भी हमसे ज़्यादा इंफॉर्मेटिव है. वो हर इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स को हर चीज़ों को हमसे बेहतर तरीके से समझता है यू नो. इसीलिए आई लव प्लांट्स. सो यू नो एक स्टूडेंट है मेरा, वो पूछा वाई यू आर यू नो आप बायोटेक्नोलॉजी के फील्ड में भी काम कर सकते हैं, वाई यू आर चूजिंग प्लांट सेक्टर यू नो. बेटा आदमी तो बता भी देगा, प्लांट कहेगा भी नहीं, उसके पास बहुत कुछ होगा. सो यू नो प्लांट्स इज रियली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू गाइज. विदाउट प्लांट वी कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग. नो 90% ऑफ द ड्रग इज इवॉल्व फ्रॉम वेयर मेडिसिन इज कमिंग फ्रॉम. सो ऑल दिस मेडिसिन इज कमिंग फ्रॉम मैक्सिमली फ्रॉम द प्लांट सोर्सेज. सो कम टू द SAR सिस्टमिक एक्वायर्ड डिजीज, सेम थिंग इज देयर. सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस. सो दिस इज एंथ्रेनोक डिजीज ऑफ ककंबर. सो एंथ्रेक्नोसिस डिजीज जो होता है वो किससे काउज होता है, राइट डाउन इनटू द माय कमेंट बॉक्स वेयर आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेंशन हियर. दिस इज अ फंगल डिजीज और आई विल ट्राई टू यू नो ट्राई टू आई जस्ट वांट टू नो फ्रॉम यू गाइस एंड व्हाट इज योर ओपिनियन अबाउट एंथ्रेनोक डिजीज बिकॉज आई हैवेंट डिस्कस अबाउट एंथ्रेनोक डिजीज इन माई causative agent. So you can learn about this disease also. This is really very very important and prominent thing. So this is the same you know, this is called as like bee are immunized, plant can also you know can immunize with that. So anthracnose disease is not going to affect the fruit part in this because these are the immunized plant. Okay, so this is really very important for you guys. Let's try to make a conclusion. So you know, before inoculation, in this case what the scientists have done, they have removed girdling, means the phloem region is removed. So if phloem region is removed, because you know the tracheids or xylem vessels are basically major part of the xylems are not very active for the pathogen interaction. So phloem is really very important and primary source. So no signal is travel through phloem. So this is the main conclusion, pathogen will travel through phloem only. So jaise hi yahan pe girdling kar diya gaya aur infection ko inoculate kiya gaya, to plant is behaving as a knife. So if you will introduce second time infection, it will show very drastic nature of immune response because girdling blocks the SAR activity. So systemic acquired resistance is not going to prominate. So this is again, so local resistance is this, and this is due to the systemic acquired resistance. Plant have experienced and learned from their past experience. Okay, so dear friend, I'm not going to discuss about this all. I will just skip. I just want to tell you one thing, that the you know systemic acquired resistance or induced systemic resistance is really very important, and this is systemic acquired resistance is generated through salicylic acid, and this PR protein will develop, and induced systemic resistance is through jasmonic acid or ethylene biosynthesis. Okay, so jasmonate and ethylene both can responsible for induced systemic resistance. This is local resistance and this is you can say global or whole plant, you know, systemic acquired resistance. Okay, so this is again very important for you guys. Same thing is given in this also. So you have to understand both induced systemic resistance, this is called ISR, or systemic acquired resistance. This all have equal impact and equal contribution in your examination. So try to know about this. So these are the PR proteins, different proteins. So I'm not going to discuss these all because they are not going to ask in any exams. But I'm interested to say this, so I have shared. So dear friend, this is about PR proteins. So I have already discussed a lot, so I'm not going to discuss. So effector molecules ko aap just dekhoge, this is the northern blot of PR protein. So in systemic acquired resistance, initially you can see this is this case. In this, if infection is happened, you can see the level of PR protein generation. So this is really very pre-activated immunity, and by the northern blot analysis this is confirmed. Okay, chali. This is SAR priming effect. How can you check the priming? So in this case, promoter ke sath kya hota, kisi bhi promoter ke sath, what you can do in transgenic line, you can use Gus gene, and you can attach your Gus gene with the promoter of that particular trait of interest. So if in this case no SAR is generated because the infection is not primed. If SAR is generated because due to prime, so you can see the intense nature of Gus expression. So this Gus expression will show you the effector molecules. Priming is very essential, which I have already discussed in that biotechnology paper also. So this again very important for you guys. So systemic acquired resistance and local resistance, systemic acquired resistance can be generated within 4 to 5 hours, and you can see if you from primary, you have to give a proper time interval. Yani ki aaj primary infection diya to kal aakar ke secondary infection de loge, the plant will show you that SAR. No, that's systemic acquired resistance is not as like that. You have to wait for 3 to 4 days for the next second inoculation, that is the secondary immune response generation. So this is all about my topic. So dear friend, you can if you want to know what type of signaling is going on, what you can do, you can take that particular generated plant, and you can try to know to the particular extract, and you can through HPLC analysis you can know which fraction is responsible for pathogenesis in the plant. That you can extract each single fraction from HPLC plot. There you can there you can elute that fraction. So you can collect that fraction, and you can know from these all fractions which fraction is more pathogenic in nature. So through this you can understand about that pattern also. Okay, so dear friend, this is really very important, and it can be epigenetically controlled, or maybe it can controlled by so practically genetically you know very much that it can be controlled, but practically epigenetically also it can control. So I have already discussed about chromatin remodeling concept. So dear friend, epigenetic silencing and transactivations, how these are happening into the plant system, so I have already discussed a lot. So dear guys, this is all about how a chrome centromeric region is condensed to form a heterochromatin, and how detach and form euchromatin, and this also can give rise to plant immune regeneration, and this pathogen immunity is also controlled epigenetically. So this is all about on and off about all about the pathways, and from this I will tell you thanks for your attention, and thank you so much for watching my lecture. Bye, take care. And I think by this note, I think you can follow on my Insta, you can WhatsApp me, you can mail me if you have any information about these things. Sure, dear friend, I will just tell you one thing, that please focus on science, try to do something extraordinary, and you know, if you have any query, try to comment on my lecture. Bye, take care, stay tuned.